How's it going, guys? This is Keith.
I'm Brandon.
And we're Tears to Embers.
This is Tears to Embers Reacts. This is our very first video in the series. And today we're going to be watching some music scenes in movies. So
let's try the first one here. So this is Rockstar, an audition scene.
I have seen this scene.
Have you?
But I've not seen this movie.
Mark Wahlberg. I think he actually sung in this.
No, wait, never mind. You know who did? Who? Miles Kennedy.
Oh my god, yes. Yeah, that's right. He's amazing. He's amazing.
He, at the end of the movie, I don't know how long it's been since you saw this. At the end of the movie, he's leaving the band, he pulls a guy up to sing in his place.
You do know
it's Miles Kennedy.
Yes, sir. Sorry about that. All right, well, we'll pick it up just coming out of the intro.
And if you notice, the band members, some of them are actual musicians.
Yes.
Like, Zach Wild, one of them.
Oh, that's cool.
He shaved his beard.
I'm sorry. We're wasting our time here. Sorry, would it be okay if I was, could I start one more time? All right, yeah, go again.
This is perfectly natural. That. Like, I mean, it's not really easy to just come straight in.
You want it cold? Yeah, but you want to, it's something funny, if you would never know this unless you recorded in a music studio. Do you notice something that's wrong, 100% wrong?
Yeah, you wouldn't be using a live
mic. You're using a live mic with no pop filter.
Yeah, no pop filter, yes.
And it's perfect. He's not going anything.
Yeah. Yet. Yeah, I mean, there's a mic right there with the pop filter and
also,
everything.
Too, you notice he's also already got auto-tune on everything. Proactively.
I mean, it's like, it's really cool seeing it. Like, it shows you, like, how cool it can be to be in a studio, especially in front of, like, really, really impressive musicians in this type of audition scene or whatever. And maybe that's why he's using a live mic, because it's just an audition. But yeah, ideally you're going to use a studio mic and it's going to have a pop filter and you're not going to be grabbing it. That's
cup that in
is,
the mic.
That is like
cup in the mic.
Everybody.
In the studio.
Yes. That's like so foobar. Like you're never going to like grab that microphone.
Like you're putting on a show in the studio.
Yeah. No, I mean, that's purely for audition and it's purely for show for the movie. And I like it's getting that emotion across, but yeah, it's totally wrong.
Oh, full on cuff.
Oh yes, he's like barely enough room for his mouth to get there. I'm gonna say it again, Miles Kennedy is amazing.
Okay.
But geez.
I think part of it was Mark Wahlberg, but I think the majority of it was him. Now,
I do love movies that do that. I'm a huge fan of movies where the actors actually do the work and actually do the singing. There was another one that was kind of a musical movie that came out, and I can't remember the name of the movie. I'm blanking on it right now, but it'll come to me later.
I mean,
it doesn't matter. It had Russell Brand in it, and
Get Him to the Greek?
No. No, though.
He was a rock star. Now.
He was. That's a good one too. We should react to that one later. But yeah, it's. I mean, it's a cool scene. It, like we said, it kind of gets the point across. It feels like it's meant to be more of an audition than anything. But again, if you're in the studio and I mean this type of scene, you're really going to be using a mic with a pop filter. You're not going to be grabbing it, and you're going to be keeping a good solid distance away from the microphone. And ideally, like when I record, we do sections of the vocals that are different volume-wise or intensity-wise. And that's just – so, again, this could be just because he's doing an audition. That could be why they're playing it out this way. But I don't know. The headphones and everything, like getting a perfect mix, it just seems weird for it to be an audition.
One thing I will mention – you see, they got one with a pop filter.
I know, I said that a second ago, and it's right there. It's right there.
Maybe they wanted that live feel, you know, even though it's already auto-tuned a bit. Still auto-tuned. Even when it's bare.
Yeah.
Zach Wild. It's cleft chin.
Yes. Yep. You're right. I didn't see him before then.
And then they're going to be like, oh, you suck. And then the movie's over.
What would you rate that on a scale of like 1 to 10 as far as like, I don't know.
Like accuracy?
Yeah, accuracy. I guess realism and accuracy.
4. I'm pretty harsh on it.
I'm going to give it a 4 as well. I mean, like I said, it could be because he's auditioning, but still, there's so much wrong with the way that they're doing it. They kind of went halfway. You know, if it's an audition.
The gear is correct as far as like.
Absolutely.
Like the recording gear is very, I think it was set in the 80s. Mm-hmm. So it's reel to reel still.
Yeah.
Like it's, I mean.
And the space is accurate. I mean, what you're seeing with all the instruments and stuff inside, that's probably
like
pretty accurate
room.
For the time. Yeah, it's like a live room.
Now, more than likely, if you really did some digging, I would imagine you'd probably, hey, he's probably wearing like those headphones, our modern day headphones.
Then maybe. It's hard to tell. I mean, they don't really like, you can't really tell what you're looking
but
at.
But at least they did a reel to reel. Like they tried to make it seem more 80s, 90s. But
yeah. But again, they kind of just went halfway.
Yeah.
They kind of just went halfway. And they bothered to show the pop filter, you know, studio mic in the background. In the foreground. Yeah. So. Yeah, I'm all right with a 4. I'd call that a 4 as well.
Okay. Next. Now, this one's, you've never seen this one.
Oh, so this is a blonde reaction. This is from Spinal Tap.
Yeah. Have you ever seen Spinal Tap?
No.
Never.
Never. Never.
You're missing out, man.
I am.
It's pretty.
They had the same luck with drummers that we did.
For a few times now. Very delicate. It's a bit of a departure from the kind of thing you normally play.
Yeah, well, it's part of a trilogy, really, a musical trilogy that I'm doing in D minor, which I always find is really the saddest of all keys, really. I don't know why, but most people weep instantly.
Guitar player, guitar player.
It's a horn bar. It's very pretty.
Before we get the rest of the way, what would you, just off of, like, right so far, what would you rank it? Pretty, I mean, it's not much.
I mean, it's not. There's not much to go on, but, like, I mean, he's sitting in front of, like, is it a tech guy or is it just a, you know, a friend of the band? I don't know, but, like, this is just him sitting and tooling around, noodling around with something that he's been working on for a while, so I'd say that's pretty accurate. I'd give that, like, a 6.
Okay. Now.
Or a 7.
We'll change your scores in a minute.
You know, just simple lines intertwining. You know, very much like I'm really influenced by Mozart and Bach, and it's sort of in between though. It's really, it's like a Mach piece, really. It's,
what do you call this?
Well, this piece is called Lick My Love Pump.
Just this so matter-of-factly. Oh, this is called Lick My Love Pump.
Now, just, what would you rank it now?
I'm going to give it a 9. I'm sorry.
Yeah, and I
exploded the microphone just then with my stupid laugh. I'm going to say a 9 because we have named songs stupider things. All
right, so the next one is another rock star scene.
Again, I haven't seen this movie.
You haven't seen this movie, Rockstar?
No. I saw the one scene, the first one.
Okay. You haven't seen the whole movie. Mm-hmm.
I need to sit down and watch it. I like Mark Wahlberg a lot.
Early 2000s, I think.
Yeah.
Again, that bugs the crap out of me. That just,
yeah.
I hate it.
He does. He hates it. I don't know why.
It's a dad thing.
It's not a dad.
It's like when Ronnie James Dio, who could be your great grandfather, used to do it. Like,
it's a universal thing.
That man
like,
brought it up,
like,
and he is dead now. That's how old that is.
It's not like it's.
It just seems like
I don't think it's lost any of its luster. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't.
I think it's so bad. I think it's like, I'm doing rock, and this is what I should do. Or does it bug me?
I like it.
Stop it.
But
not only does he do the dad move in here, but he does it breaking the fourth wall because that camera should not exist in that world.
I thought maybe the drummer was behind him.
Yeah, he's underneath him.
So where is he located at on the stage? Is he above?
So he's on the staircase, and below him is the drummer, and he's going to probably walk down the stairs.
That's a huge God, exactly. I play on the stage that big. We haven't played on the stage this long. I see what you're saying. Yeah, the drummer's below him, so who is he to? Like,
yeah.
Oh my God, dude. Oh my God.
Oof. Boom. How would you feel if you're on a stage that big and did that?
Oh my God, man. I'm going to be honest. That's super real. Like, any stage you're on, doesn't matter how big, whatever, you have to be superbly aware of your footing. Like, I have been on stages before where they had a little walkout section, or where, you know, you get really close to the edge and you just have to, I get getting into the moment. Entirely possible to do that. But
you ever notice too that we played for bands, and we've been with, you know, played with touring bands, and a lot of times they don't want you to outdo them, so they're like, oh, you have to just go around our stuff. Mm-hmm. And then the stage
the
gets
stage
smaller
shrinks.
And smaller.
Yes. Like that.
And so that's that, because they don't want you to move around much. And then you're like, oh, I can't I'm gonna fall off.
At least two that I can think of, where you have a fraction of the stage. Like, you have all of the touring band's gear is already loaded on behind you because they just want to come out and sit down at their stuff, or sit down at the drums and come out and just be hooked up and ready to go. So you end up with like an eighth of the stage width-wise.
They're like, we don't have room for your scrims. I did before.
I did before you made me take them down. Like, you know, we've had gear on stage before. Like, had it worked out and everything, and had people come up and tell us to take it down because there wasn't enough room. And I'm like, there was, because it was there. But okay, cool, whatever. This is like, that's savage though. That's like,
In the movie, in context of the movie, this is his first show playing with that big band too.
Oh my God, that's terrible.
Well, you can watch.
I can imagine it would be that, like, stunning as well. Like, not only does he
probably got a concussion.
Yeah. But not only that, but all the sound and the crowd and everything. Oh, man. It doesn't get much more metal than that.
He recovers.
Yeah, that's nice. I'm not saying it's not possible, but to be that aware and just to keep rolling, I don't know. But people have had that kind of injury before. People have had that kind of injury before on stage and kept on going.
What a screenshot.
That's the thumbnail.
Yeah.
That's the thumbnail for our video. Yeah, Mark Wahlberg with blood on his face, spraying people in the audience with his hose.
Before we get too far into this, we did not rank the last scene.
Oh, I'm going to give that an 8. I'm going to give it an 8. I mean, but just because, like, I don't know how realistic it is to jump back into that level of singing after that kind of injury. But I'm not going to say it's not possible. And it's definitely possible to lose your footing on stage like that when you're really just into the moment. And
I'm going to give it a 5.
Okay.
And
what's your reasoning?
The good parts was it didn't sound too studio. They did put reverb on it. They put reverb on his voice. Yeah. It wasn't super auto-tuned. So you sold the fact that it could be live. So I give him that much. But, you know, the devil horns, man.
The fourth wall break with the devil horns is what ruined the scene for him.
Like,
I mean, at least it's still a 5, so you're halfway to 10. But that's a huge drop,
yeah,
you know,
well,
just for the fourth wall break.
You probably lost 3 points on that.
Next clip we're going to do is Rocket Man.
Cool. I have not seen this movie.
So it's got Taron Egerton in it.
I did not realize it was him until just now. Like, I've seen the previews and stuff of the movie.
He actually sang all the parts in this one.
That's really cool. I like that. Did he also sing the parts in Sing? That's awesome. I like that. It does sound different.
Yeah.
One thing that bugs me about this movie is, and I've seen the movie, but this movie's more of like a musical. I'm not a fan of musicals. I don't like somebody like coming out in their kitchen and being like, oh, I'm going to sing about some cheese, you know? Like, it makes no sense why you would break out into song just randomly.
Yeah.
Like,
well, it's a genre.
Well,
own,
and like they, know? The way they do it here is like it it's a musical where part
only,
of it's in a concert
only,
and some of it's like it's weird. It's kind of like psychedelic-y kind of. What bugs me, like if when we're talking about accuracy, like he was singing the chorus of the song and he wasn't even nowhere near a mic and he's in a stadium.
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
God mode.
he's performing in God mode. Right?
Yeah, he's got.
Yeah, you know, I really just didn't pay attention, but I guess, you know, that's a common theme with musicals. So I let that slide because it's not meant to be an accurate representation of a live
we're
concert.
We're judging accuracy, though.
We are. To be fair, we are. So it with me personally, it gets a pass because I understand that it's meant to be a musical and they have a certain way that they portray things visually. But yeah, if we're rating it for realism in like real life,
and
yeah, he's nowhere near a microphone. He's not wearing
an, even when
you know,
he does. Yeah, he doesn't have any in-ears. Which
yeah.
This was in the like I think the
yeah,
70s or 80s, so they wouldn't have had them.
Yeah,
they would have had monitors in the front of the stage. But the other thing that bugs me, and I could be wrong, they may have used these for vocals, but that microphone on the stand
yeah.
is an SM57. And SM57s are usually used for either cabinet mics for guitar.
They're directional.
So
sound goes directly.
You can't use them for vocals because it's usually a vocal mic is omnidirectional.
It's a cardioid mic, and you can literally the sound goes in from the sides, up, down, everywhere, basically.
But this mic that you see on screen is very pointed, and usually one of two things I've ever used it for is a cabinet mic when you're micing up cabinets,
or like
for a guitar cabinet, or a drum mic, and usually it's the underside of a snare drum is what I've seen it on.
Yeah.
So
the sound's very direct.
To say, like, unless he's right up on it like this,
yeah,
like he's not going to use it for vocals.
Which he is. He's getting close, but
here's the thing, though.
Off to the side.
Here's the other thing. He's in God mode anyway, so I think
it's
the same.
So it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
And now he's leaning his head back again, so like it's all about the performance at this point.
And then now he's up.
Yeah.
He's not even. The piano is still going, by the way.
Okay. Yeah.
And now he's turning into a rocket.
Okay. I'm not gonna judge this because there's another movie that I want us to react to later on that does something really crazy like this.
What?
But,
okay, before we cut it off, this is the last video for this one. What would you rank this one?
Okay, all right. This is tough because like I really want to rate it high because I like musicals. I think they're really enjoyable. I think they're engaging, and like I want to give them a pass because I know that they try to go for visuals as well as the, you know, the audio and everything. But realism, this is going to be like a 3.
I'm going to give it a 1.
You're going to give it a 1? That's harsh.
I should probably give it a 2.
I've yet to
ever be in a big room like that and be able to carry my voice to like 50,000 people.
Yeah.
And then I've never also turned into a rocket.
Me either. Now, this could be just a big metaphor for how he's feeling in that moment.
He could
still
be high from earlier.
It could
could not be metaphorical.
He could be like swimming on the, laying on the stage.
Making mouth that's sounds.
That's realistic, yeah.
That's where the realism is, kids.
Yeah.
So, yeah. A three for me is giving it a pass.
And it's a one.
Yeah.
One, so. All day long. So that was our first reaction video. We're going to be, two or three parts to this. So, appreciate you stopping in.
Please like the video and subscribe if you haven't already. And drop us some comments below, guys. And if there's something that you guys want us to react to, please leave it in the comments. We want to do a whole lot of these. I like reaction videos. And a lot, especially if it's something I haven't seen before, please drop it in the comments. Let us know what you want us to do. So, see you guys. See you.